Take two. This is the 2019 Infinity Whiplash. This board is our flat water to mild chop specialty race board design. This board excels in flat water conditions, maintaining excellent glide per stroke, and it's a really quiet, clean, displacement style hull. This is the nose for 2019. Same reverse bow style design we've been using on this board the last couple years. Reverse bow meaning it's V'd on the top and flat on the bottom. We like this style nose because it's really sharp and pointy. That's enough to part the water efficiently, but it's flat on the bottom, which makes it really forgiving. When chop or swell come from different direction, it tends to roll right under rather than grabbing and picking up the board off course. So it's a much more versatile displacement style design. You can see the V on the deck is quite aggressive, stays pretty radical all the way to the point of the cockpit. And this just directs water, if it comes up on the deck, right off the board. And you can see it kind of tapers and falls off before the cockpit. So any water that's coming this way is encouraged to leave the deck before it gets to the standing zone. This year we do offer a carbon fiber splash guard water deflector. It basically deflects any water that comes over the deck. If water does enter the cockpit at all, we have four scupper holes that take care of that right away. And we also covered the scupper holes with some speed covers on the outside as well. The front of the board is really efficient and narrow. The rails got a little bit more squared up, and what that did was allow us to blend in that rail into the cockpit area. And this upright rail allowed us to push the width of the cockpit out further towards the rail, and we gained about 1.5 inches wider standing zone. More features on the top as you come back. This is our air vent. This is an FCS plug which can adapt to your GPS, speed coach. There's water bottle attachments, obviously a GoPro as well. We've added handles options on either side rail, left hand or right hand. This is for beach starts. The traction pad is the same as last year. It's a closed cell, heat pressed, high density EVA. So it does not soak up water, stays nice and dry. And the grip is an elongated diamond that's really comfortable, and especially comfortable over long courses when you're doing lots of miles. We have our standard Speed Freaks handle, extra large handle, padded neoprene, really comfortable and really durable. This year, you can see we progressed it into a flat deck. So right in front of the fin box and over the fin, it's flat. So this just gives a little bit more room to move about the tail for stepping back if you're gonna ride a wave, for buoy turns. It's just more free and you don't feel this sidewall. The tail's also really thick, so the thick tail basically balances out the hull of the volume. If you notice this board, if you're sprinting, you're at 80% race pace, our boards tend to plane more evenly than a lot of boards, and that's just because the hull is balanced. So we like to encourage lift out the back of the tail. So when you're sprinting, it's sprinting more evenly rather than sagging the tail. And that has to do with the bottom and the exit of this board. This board finishes out on a nice square tail for stability, keeps the outline parallel for stability, and also gets the water a faster way to leave the board. It's not fighting around a curve, it's going straight down a line. So it enters the front of the board and it's just thinking about leaving the board. The idea with this board is ultimate glide per stroke. You're going to be able to maintain your top speeds easier at a slower stroke rate, faster with less effort. That's what we're all trying to achieve. Let's take a look at the bottom of the Whiplash. So the reason why I call it a hybrid displacement board is because it's got a lot of concave, and most displacement boards are basically V'd out, maybe rolled hulls, flat bottoms. This Whiplash has a V, but it's a reverse V. It's not a concave, it's not round at the bottom. It comes to a point. And it's the same concept we're using on our Blackfish board, but we've tweaked it for more of a displacement application. And how we did that was, when it enters the nose, you can see it's a little crowned right here, but not sharp. And that just does the job of parting the water until it reaches the entrance of this reversed V. And the reversed V runs down the center of the board. So we're able to maintain a really flat rocker down the center line and a curvier rocker on the rail line. Another good thing about the reverse V, it's forcing the water to the center. So this is gonna help with tracking. The water kind of gets cradled to the center, so it's helping the board go straight, as well as helping the board find the exit. We're forcing water to the center while the outside rail is releasing it away. It enters the front. You can see it's quite round, starts flattening up. Right about here is flatter. So this gives it side-to-side stability and sure-footedness. And then it starts bending down to the exit corner. The unique thing about this design is tricking the water to think this board is a really narrow pintail, but maintaining the stability and the volume of a square tail. We achieve that is from the release point of this board, there's a really hard edge. What that is doing is creating lift from the center. It's squeezing and lifting the tail as it exits the board. And when it exits the board, by that time, the water is coming off this real narrow pin edge. If you're drafting this board, you'll notice the draft is really flat and it's really, really narrow. The draft looks like a pintail board when you're behind it. Had some great results last year. Shea Foudy, she sealed up the APP World title in France. She rode this in the distance race, and the distance race was quite choppy, and she did really well. This has also been a favorite of Candace Appleby over the years. Candace Appleby has won multiple races on this board. Itzel Delgado won the 200 meter sprint races in Hossegor against some of the fastest guys on the planet. So that was kind of a coming out party for this board. It's been a really cool board, and it's been more versatile really than we wanted. But guys are choosing it when it's just calm and they're really looking for that glide. And that's it. That's the 2019 Infinity Whiplash. If you're looking for the ultimate flat water efficiency, excellent glide per stroke, and just a really quiet, fun flat water board to paddle really fast, look no further than Infinity Whiplash. Thanks for tuning in.